Hello students, since we are discussing about the sterility indicators, right? So here is the third method, that is the called biological indicator. In biological indicator, we are going to use the microorganisms itself to know about the what is the level of sterilization, right? So this is the third one, biological indicator, right? These are the, it contains, biological indicator contains of a suitable microorganism. Let me tell you that we are going to use the microorganisms only deposited on a carrier or placed in a load, whatever the things we are sterilizing in the, with that it will be placed or it will be keep over there, right? Then after sterilization, whenever the sterilization will complete, whatever the hot air oven or autoclave or dry heat or moisture, whatever you are using, after sterilization, this microorganism has to be collected and they are checked for viable microorganisms, which is going to show you the effectiveness of the sterilization taken place, right? Indicating effectiveness of the process, that's what it is indicating, the what is the effectiveness of the particular process of sterilization which you have done, right? So the microorganism which we are using for biological as a biological indicator, this microorganism should used should possess the different ability, right? What is the ability it is supposed to have? It should be highly resistant to sterilizing agent. If there will be not be resistance, what will happen? They may itself will die and will not be able to recover them later on, and will not be able to know the what is the things happen during the sterilization, right? And genetically they should be stable, they should not be manipulated, and they should be non-pathogenic. That's very very important, because this microorganism we are going to use along with our formulations, along with the nutrient media which we are sterilizing, we are removing the microorganism, and if they will be pathogenic, again the entire process is going to be fail, right? That's what these three ability is supposed to have, the microorganism which we are using as a biological indicator. So where we can use here, for example, in autoclave we are going to use the Bacillus stereothermophiles. This is the name of the bacteria which we can use as a biological indicator. In dry heat sterilization in 160 degree centigrade temperature, Bacillus subtilis we can use. In ethylene oxide sterilization, we can use the Bacillus subtilis once again, and the membrane filtration, Pseudomonas, then Dyneminuta, this can be used as a biological indicator. That's what it is known as, a biological indicator. Biological things or living organisms we are going to use as an indicator, not like a physical indicator or chemical indicator, right? And those living organisms, those microorganisms, it is going to tell you the entire story, what happened during the sterilization process, up to how much temperature we have gone, up to how much level of the destruction we have achieved, all those things. Thank you, students.